Hi everyone, and welcome to the San Diego Zoo Kids Corner. I'm Dr. Zulidal from the world famous San Diego Zoo. You won't believe the stories that I have got to tell you, and the amazing animals that I have met on my many adventures. I cannot wait to share all my stories with you. So buckle up, because we're about to bring the zoo to you. Well, today's episode, we have got special guests for you to meet. We've got some videos to show you. And of course, there's going to be some jokes. Everything is going to be about animals. But before we get started, I need to hear your favorite animal. Just go ahead, shout out your favorite animal. Let me know what it is. Oh, I'm far away. You need to be a bit louder than that. Oh, I heard lion. Yep, lions. Rhinos are good. Monkeys. A lot of people like monkeys. They're so much fun to watch. Let me tell you a secret. My favorite animal are the Madagascar hissing cockroaches. That's right, I love cockroaches. Okay, whatever your favorite animal is, it's gonna be a wild ride and we're gonna have so much fun together. Are you ready to find out what today's theme is? Okay, I'm gonna need a drum roll, please. Drum roll, bum, drum roll. Today's theme is the place where animals live. Do you know what those two words are that make up the place where animals live? That's right. Today's theme is animal habitats. Okay, let's define animal habitats. An animal habitat is made up of... Ooh. A habitat is... Oh. I can't remember. You know, I'm going to need some help, and I know just the celebrity who can help me out. This is someone who you can see at the world-famous San Diego Zoo. Her brother is at the San Diego Zoo Safari Park. So ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's put your hands together, because let's welcome to the San Diego Zoo Kids Corner, Roberta the Zebra, and the crowd goes wild. Hi, Roberta. Welcome to the San Diego Zoo Kids Corner. We desperately need your help. You have to tell us what is a habitat and what makes up a habitat and how animals move about the habitat. Can you help us with that, Roberta? Oh, and Roberta, we need one more thing. We need a good animal joke. Deal? Deal.
Hi, Dr. Z. I'm here in my habitat. My habitat is the African savanna. Now, a habitat is made up of four things: food, water, shelter, and space. Now, in a habitat, there's food for me to eat. As a zebra, I like to eat grass and hay. Lots of veggies. Well, and then there's lions. Lions like to eat zebras. Ooh. Well, there's also water to drink. And some animals drink a lot of water, like elephants. And some animals drink none, like koalas. I love to drink water. Now, shelter is important too. That's some place that I can hide or get shade from the beating sun and pouring rain. But sometimes we just get a little wet. And space is important too. But I'm not talking about outer space, although it would be cool to be the first zebra on the moon. Space is an area that I can move around in. As a zebra, we need a lot of space. Because if my mom and my dad and my stinky brother Robert all stayed in the same place, we'd eat up all the hay. So it's important for us to keep moving. Now, all four of these elements make up every animal's habitat. And each animal has a different habitat. Okay, try to test me. Shout out your favorite animal. I will take the top suggestions and yell out their habitat. Ooh, I heard polar bear. That's right, polar bears live in the Arctic. and they eat seals. That's the food in their habitat. And there's definitely lots of water up there. Polar bears? Well, they shelter inside of ice caves. Oh, I heard lion. Well, lions live in the African savanna, and they eat meat. And yeah, they also drink water from the watering hole, just like I do. And they also shelter in the trees. And they take up a lot of space in that African savanna. Oh, I heard someone hoot out owl. They're really cool. They're small and love to eat bugs, and they get water from rivers. Now, what's really cool is they shelter in tunnels made by ground squirrels or other diggers that have left their homes. And their space is right here in San Diego. Whew, that was hard. I think I have a headache. Dr. Zulittle, you wanted a joke? Well, what's black and white and red all over? A sunburnt zebra! Isn't that the best joke you heard all day?
Thanks, Roberta. That was so helpful. Habitats are made up of food, water, shelter, and what's that last one? Space, that's right. Good job. The joke? Not so much. We'll have to get you some help on those jokes. But we humans have habitats as well. And right now, it's time to introduce you to our second guest. It's my identical twin brother. Now, I don't want you to think it's me. It's not me doing a remote somewhere else. This is my actual identical twin brother, and he's going to show you around his habitat. Hi, brother. Are you there?
Well, I happen to be in an open space, which is one thing that is needed in a habitat. The other thing is you must have a food source, which is my tomato plant. Look, and it's even growing tomatoes. Of course, we also have basil and rosemary. The other important aspect of a habitat is having a water supply.
And shelter.
Didn't I tell you he was my identical twin brother? I mean, it's amazing. Now, I'm going to tell you the secret on how to tell us apart. I have a tail. Absolutely true. In fact, I have more tails than there are animals at the San Diego Zoo. I bet you have a tail too. If you came up to me and said, Dr. Zulittle, I have a tail, I would sit down and listen to your tale. I have so many tales that I plan on sharing with you. My brother, Dr. Zulittle, no tales whatsoever. I heard that. Okay, it's time for our video. And this video is of a habitat in Africa. It's the baobab tree. It's an amazing habitat. Do you know what a baobab tree is? This is what it looks like. So watch the video and we'll chat on the other side.
The wildlands of Madagascar are home to an incredible variety of rare and strange creatures that live in unique habitats on the island. Each inhabitant has perfectly adapted to life on the island over millions of years of isolation. And now, this curious wonderland continues to amaze us with its bizarre yet astonishing beauty. But perhaps the title of most unique and versatile landscape belongs to the Spiny Forest of southwest Madagascar. At first glance, this strange habitat may appear to be dry, harsh, and desolate. But upon closer inspection, it is quite the opposite. This forest is teeming with life, and if you look hard enough, some rare treasures can be found. A gecko has sought refuge in the crack of one of the most iconic trees in the forest. This majestic marvel is the baobab tree. Reaching heights of up to 100 feet tall, they are often nicknamed the upside down tree for their root-like branches. But regardless of their appearance, these baobabs play a very important role in the Spiny Forest. Not only do their cracks and crevices provide a safe home for many locals, they also grow a nutrient-rich fruit that help to feed the forest. But how does the baobab look after itself in such a harsh, dry climate? An ingenious adaptation allows the tree to store water. A large baobab can hold thousands of gallons of water, earning it another apt nickname, the bottle tree. The baobab isn't the only unique flora doing its part to keep the spiny forest functioning. Another remarkable plant, commonly known as the octopus tree, grows juicy flowers and moist leaves that attract hungry stomachs. Even though the octopus tree does its best to defend itself by disguising sharp thorns amongst the leaves, the lure of a tasty treat is too strong for some lemurs. This biodiversity hotspot is just one of many landscapes that make up the true beauty of this magical island. But wherever you look, you'll be amazed to see how the plants and animals coexist and interact to make Madagascar one of the most unique places on Earth.
Wasn't that tree amazing? In fact, I've been to a baobab tree in Zimbabwe that can hold 40 people on the inside. Just imagine that. That's your whole class, your teacher, the principal, Dr. Zulittle, Dr. Zulittle's identical twin brother, the lunch lady, and the PE coach all inside the tree at the same time. Well, it's time for our pop quiz. Let's see how well you paid attention to the baobab tree. Here goes. Shout out the answers if you know them. Question number one. Where did the lemur find food in its habitat? If you said the leaves and the fruit of the baobab tree, you're absolutely correct. Question number two. Where did the gecko find shelter in the baobab tree? The gecko finds shelter in the cracks of the baobab tree. Question number three. How does the baobab tree survive the dry season? Correct, good job. The baobab tree can hold thousands of liters in its trunk. Final question. What is the nickname of the baobab tree? If you said bottle tree, you're absolutely correct. Think of all that water it can store in its trunk. Good job, everyone. And if you want to see a baobab tree in person, just come to the San Diego Zoo. We've got one in Africa Rocks. Okay, it's time to check in with my identical twin brother, and he's going to show you how animals move about their habitat. Let's see if you can keep up with him. Brother, are you there?
Yes, I've hired a drill instructor who is going to be taking us through movement like an animal. So follow me and we'll give you an introduction.
Introducing Dr. Zulittle.
Thank you very much. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic. I'm here with my drill instructor, Maisie Rose, and she is going to take us all through how animals move in their habitat. Okay, Miss Maisie Rose, what do you think about leafcutter ants? Oh, yes, they march. That's true. Okay, great. So now we're going to do the lizard crawl. What does the lizard crawl look like? Oh, yeah, there we go. Fantastic. You know, most lizards will crawl with one opposite arm and leg at the same time. Can you do the opposite arm and leg at the same time? Opposite arm and leg at the same time. You want to try that? Opposite arm and leg at the same time? No, I guess I'm the only one working out today. Fantastic. Just like a normal drill instructor. Okay, great. Sway like a tree. What does that look like? Oh, yeah. This is like the break part. This is fantastic. Did you know that trees sway in the wind? The bark helps protect the tree. But most people think that the trunk of a tree is very rigid, but it's not. It actually sways in the breeze as well. Oh, we're gonna stay in this one for a long time. I love it. Oh yes, back to work. Okay, jump like an insect. This is good. All right, fantastic. We are now onto our primate pose. What do you think about that? Ooh. Oh yeah, that looks like a gorilla. Oh yeah, swinging through the trees like the chimpanzee. That's fantastic. Oh, how about the orangutan? They have really long, really long arms. Fantastic. And back to the gorilla. Fantastic. And last but not least, we have the gecko plank.
What's a gecko plank?
Oh, I'll show you. So a gecko plank looks like this. You get down on your arms with your feet on the ground, and then we're, aye! And a lot of lizards and geckos will actually do push-ups to show off to other lizards and geckos. Dr. Zoolittle out!
Wow, that looked like a lot of work to me. My favorite one was the tree swaying. The gecko plank, that was really hard. Adults, let me help you out. If you have to do a gecko plank, you can do it this way over here. That's the way I intend to do it. Okay, let's see how many moves you remembered. I'm gonna call them out and you get to act them out. Are you ready? Let's go. Ants marching. Insect leap. Gecko plank. Tree swaying around. Primate pose. Gecko plank. Insect leap. Wow, you guys did an amazing job. That is fantastic. Good work. Okay, we want to leave you with some fun projects that you can do at home. Here they are. Oh. This is a great idea of something you can do at home. Are you ready? You know, I'm not so good at this. Roberta, do you have any suggestions of things that our friends can do at home?
Well, there's lots of things that you can do at home. Maybe head outside with a sibling or a grown-up to practice your animal workout moves. You can play your favorite song and have an animal moves dance party. And you can share your animal moves with a friend or a family member over video chat. You can even write a poem or a story describing how your favorite animal moves through their habitat.
Okay, everyone, Roberta suggested writing a poem, and while she was talking to you, I did indeed write a poem. My poem is entitled, I Love Cockroaches by Dr. E. Zoolittle, Poet Laureate of the world famous San Diego Zoo. Here it is. I love cockroaches. They come out at night, to your pet's delight. They scurry from light, and they give your mom a fright. And that's why I love cockroaches. The end. We've come to the end of this amazing episode, and I want to see if I remember everything that we learned. So let's see, a habitat is made up of four things. Let's see if we can do it from the top to the bottom, bottom to the top, forwards, backwards. Let's see if we get it right. Try keep up with me, maybe even go faster than I go. Are you ready? Food, water, shelter, space. Let's start at the bottom. Space, shelter, water, food. Let's go backwards. Food, backwards. Doof, water, retor, shelter, retless. Space, oh, that's an easy one. Ecaps. Can you speak backwards? What can you say backwards? How about your name? Dr. Zoolittle. Oh, that's hard. Rotcod Etel Ooze. Got it! We want to hear from you. Remember, you can send us your questions, your jokes, your stories, your poems, anything you want. You can email us at Z, which stands for Zebra and Zoolittle, mail@sandiegozoo.org. Get an adult to help you out. Send us those questions, those jokes, those stories, those poems. And if we use your suggestion, we'll mention your name on the air. So until next time, see you soon.